this is Chris calling from weeweeblogs.com, and today I am joined by Patrick and Misha, and we are talking about the German national final for Eurovision 2015, Unser Song für Österreich. Now, we have got 8 acts to talk about. All 8 acts will take part in the first round of the competition before 4 will move on into the second round. So they've literally just announced the running order as we're going to be putting this up. So first up is the duo, Mrs. Greenbird. So Patrick, do you want to tell a little bit more about them and what you think?
Okay, Mrs. Greenbird is probably the most popular act in the national selection this year. They won The Voice of Germany, I think, 2 years ago. They released many hits in Germany. They were like always on the chart, and everybody was so excited about them taking part. But after everybody heard the songs, they were really disappointed, and that's really sad. So I expected them more as well, but I think they're a wonderful act, and yeah, I really like them.
And
yeah, that song is very nice. It's shiny, as the name says, but I find her the lead singer's voice a little bit annoying. It's a little bit squeaky. I don't like that.
They're a very kind of happy-go-lucky kind of band, I think. Like, they are very, I suppose the word to use is kind of like twee, and just all very nice and nice. And, you know, the title of the song says it all, Shine, Shine, Shine.
Kind of
says it all. But, Patrick, you were saying that the lead singer's voice is apparently going as well, which isn't going to help matters.
Yeah. The Mrs. Greenbird just tweeted that she is sick and she has no voice right now. So I hope for the best for Thursday that she will have power again and do the best, I hope for it, but I mean, if they started the first and then she's sick, that's a bad thing. So I really hope for the best for them.
Maybe bad things will come in threes then and it won't be very good for them. Now next up is Alexa Faser, I think her name is. Is that
yes.
How you say it? Faser,
yes.
Maybe. Who is a singer-songwriter. She is performing the song Gluck in the first round. So what are our thoughts on that one?
Well, Alexa Faser is like a rising star in Germany. Like, she has her own commercial, that she has a new album, Gold von Morgen, which is apparently a song, her second song.
Yeah.
She's really getting popular in Germany, and her voice is really special, so I think many people will like her. That kind of music is really popular in Germany right now. Like, many artists are trying to reach people with the German language, so I think that she could do really well. But she sing Gluck at the first. I personally think that's a better song of those songs, but I'm not sure about it. I'm not sure how people will react.
Alexa's voice is really, really nice. I like it. It's quite powerful. But her live performance, as it was in the video of Luke, is quite weak. I don't like she was performing like she doesn't care at all. She doesn't care about the song. She doesn't care about the audience. She was just singing and walking around. And the song itself was a little bit boring, in my opinion.
I know, it's interesting that you said that she's kind of this rising star, Patrick, because I know her other song is Wir sind hier, which I think is a couple, was that like late last year?
That's like a big hit. That was a big hit in Germany, and it was all over the radio stations, and even in Austria they played the song. So she is kind of a no name, but some people know her. So I think that's a good thing for her. That could end up really well.
But I think that's kind of like the best song that I've heard from her. I kind of like Gluck. I prefer her other song. Was that Wir sind...
Gold von Morgen.
Yeah, Gold von Morgen. Sorry. That's the one that I prefer out of the two. So if she does make it through to the second round, I think that she could be in with a chance sort of later on in the competition. But obviously it's not necessarily a great thing to lead with maybe a weaker song, but so it's a bit up in the air. Third in the running order, Faun. This is my great work in German. I did actually do German. Not that you could tell, listeners, of course. Now, they're a band, and they are singing Hörst du die Trommeln first. Yes. And what are our thoughts on that one?
Well, actually, Fountain itself is like really working a long time now in that business. They had so many concerts through Germany, and I think that style of music is really popular in Germany. Like last year, we saw that I don't remember the name of the guys who said Santiano. They did it last year as well, and they came into the next round. And it's really mystical. It's dark. It's like fairies in the woods, and it's a strong thing in my opinion. And I think they could do really well. I think not in Eurovision, but they would get lost in Vienna. If they do a great performance, maybe they will be in the top 15. But no, I don't think they will win. But it's a nice song. I mean, the melody is strong, and the vocalist can't sing. The male vocalist can't sing, in my opinion. So I'm not sure about that.
Misha?
But I really like this song. It has such a great medieval spirit. It gets me to some medieval times with knights, castles, peasants, with all those traditional dancing around the fireplace. And it creates such a nice atmosphere. It makes you dreaming. And I like it. It's really nice.
I'm not convinced on them. I think that's my thing. I think that they would be quite different, and they would stand out if they made it to Eurovision, because I don't really think that there's anything like that that has been picked so far, which is probably a good thing for Germany. But I have a feeling that they'd kind of be a bit like we all thought Eliza would do. Everybody thought Eliza were probably doomed for like the bottom three, and they ended up overperforming in some people's eyes. So I think that they would probably be sort of there or thereabouts in the mid-table, but where we've got a lot of the top five countries, or the top six if you include Australia, where everybody is rating them so highly so far this year, I think that Found probably wouldn't be anything that special.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I think that would hurt Germany if they sent them. As you said, and I said that they would get lost in Vienna, in my opinion. Like, there are really more stronger songs, and I think that if they would have another song, a more stronger song, a bit more amazing, they could do better. But I'm not sure about them.
Oh, dear, for Found then. Now, this is good, because the next act is actually one that I can pronounce because it's an English language name. It's Noise Generation up next with A Song For You. Now, is this the song for you, Patrick?
Well, I'm not sure. it's about, like, Avicii style, and I'm not the biggest fan of Avicii, actually. The song itself is quite nice. It's really like poppy and a bit dancey. Not the usual dance song, but it's kind of okay for the. It's modern and it's good. Noise Generation itself is not really popular in Germany. Like I didn't hear about them before the national selection, and I think many people would think like that as well. Yeah, the lead singer itself, he's not German. That's featuring Patrick something. He's not German. I think he's from France or from Luxembourg. I'm not sure about that, but I'm not the biggest fan of it. I think they will go to the top four, to the next round, because it's really filled with energy. But no, I'm not a fan of it.
Misha?
Yeah, it's a dancing song. I don't like dancing song so much. And in this particular song, you think that you should be dancing, but then it doesn't have so much energy. I don't feel it. It's kind of a little bit depressing. I don't know. I can imagine dancing under it if I'm really, really tired and bored in some club. And that's it. But no.
Yeah, they're not, again, it's sort of that thing where if you were to think of where they would be at Eurovision, I don't think that any Noise Generation song would quite be right at Eurovision, and I think that they would kind of get lost in the crowd, even with a sound that might be different. I think that it would just not fit in with the general theme that Eurovision seems to be going with this year. I do think that they will probably make it through to the second round, though, just because it is, compared with the other songs in Unser Song for Österreich, I think it's probably one of the better ones, but that's my opinion, at least, that it does just kind of claw into that top four that we're looking at. Now, up next is Anne-Sophie. Now, if you didn't know, Anne-Sophie is kind of a bit of an unknown name. She is the winner of the wildcard round, which, of course, Eliza won last year and obviously went on to represent Germany. So could it be that the wildcard wins 2 years in a row?
Yes, it can. Yeah, I think so. Anne-Sophie is really... Nobody knew her before, and she's like the newcomer. She's fresh. She's amazing. She looks amazing. Her voice is great, and the song is really something special, not the usual Eurovision song we expect from Germany. And as you said, Eliza won it last year, so I think there is a lot going on with the wild card because people know it already, and they said, "Yeah, I voted for that in the wild card round, so why shouldn't I vote for it now?" And oh yeah, that's the song, I remember it. I think many people will think like that, and I think she will go definitely to the top four.
Yeah, I like the song. I like her attitude on stage. She has a really energetic performance, energetic song. It's really entertaining. It's a nice and catchy tune, which doesn't let you bored. So I think it really can get through, even the win the call scene. Well, who knows?
Do you think that there's a chance that if Anne-Sophie were to win, and then the wild card has won 2 years in a row, that they might just scrap the whole unsung format and then just run with the club concert? Because then if you're thinking 2 years in a row, the unknown act has won, one, if you're a big name act, why would you put yourself up against them? And two, sort of, have we already made our decision, you know, 3 or 4 weeks beforehand?
I think it won't be a good idea if they just do the club concert, because there was only one good song, and the good song won. The rest was totally shite. So I think that would be a bad decision if they do that. If they pick better songs, it would be a good idea. But I don't like the whole format. It's kind of weird with all this, with the first round, the second round, and then the final round, and with all the singers have two songs. It's a bit old. I don't like the format, and I don't think that it would be a good idea just if they do the club concert.
In my opinion, the singers should focus on one song to make it better, make the performance better, and then it can really get something fresh and really great.
I think that the very first year that they kind of did the kind of like the Melody Festival and style final, or the Melody Grand Prix style final, which was 2013, I think, when Cascada won, that was probably one of the best national finals that I've ever seen in terms of the quality of the songs, in terms of the performances. Maybe not with the fact that La Brass Banda nearly won the entire thing. That probably wouldn't have been a good thing, but that was probably one of the best quality national finals. And the fact that they've tinkered with the format a bit, I think, has kind of taken some of the edge off on the Unsung format. So maybe it wouldn't be a good idea, and I don't think it would be a good idea if they were to just run with club concert, but maybe it might need a bit of tinkering for next year. That might just be a thing that they need to look at. However, of course, if it picks a Eurovision winner, who knows? And speaking of Eurovision winners, they're not on stage with a Eurovision winner, but they have worked with one. It's the next group, which is Fahrenheit. Now, they have worked with Emily DeForest before, and there was a big will they, won't they bring her on stage with them for Unsersong for Österreich? Of course they're not, but what do we think about their songs and their chances? Their first song is Frozen Silence. So what do we think?
I think Fahrenheit is the best act in the national selection by far. They are really not really known in Germany. Some people know them, but not everybody, not like Mrs. Greenbird. They're a little bit more unknown. But I think it's time to see something really fresh in Eurovision, and Fahrenheit is fresh. They have this special music tune in their songs, like really mystic, and I always get goosebumps when I listen to Frozen Silence, so I think that's a really good sign. Yeah, and the fact that they won't do it with Emily DeForest is kind of good for me, because I think they would have not get a chance to go to Eurovision, because it's, we don't need the Danish one, and she had her time in Eurovision. So I'm glad that they pick Amanda Pedersen. It's still a Danish one.
Yeah.
I love this song. It's really something special. It is so magical. It's like teleports you into another universe where everything is so pure and bright. Like you can see also snowy mountains, some lakes, and it really makes you dreaming. And even so, it's shiny, but it shines with some colder light because the name is Frozen Silence. And you can feel this frozen energy, and I love it twice because I grew up in cold, and it really makes me something special for me.
They are definitely sort of a very different kind of feel. It's almost something you would expect from, like, it's a bit probably like stereotyping with something like an Iceland or somewhere like that, maybe not Germany, but they do have something very kind of unique about them. And whereas we're saying at sort of like Faun or Noise Generation, where they've got a unique kind of slant to them compared with the rest of the acts, I think they would actually do really well at Eurovision. I could definitely see them sort of getting into the top 10, bringing Germany back to the top 10 as well, which is obviously something that we're looking for here in these acts.
And many Germans see a really high potential in Fahrenheit. They think, if we send them, we were gonna win. I don't think they will win with Fahrenheit, but they could really place well even in the top 10. Mm-hmm. And the fact that it's like recorded in Austria and in Switzerland, the video, is kind of really good for the Eurovision, especially if it's in Austria. And I think if they do a good performance on the stage with the staging, with the coldness behind them, it could work. But if they don't do it, it maybe could get lost, because the video is so impressive, and you're like, oh my god, this video. And if you're seeing them on stage without anything special, it won't work. But I hope they will do a great performance.
Definitely. So, next up, from one kind of group to another, this time it's an all-girl group. It is Lang with Zeig Deine Muskeln. Is that right?
Yes.
They've gone back to German now, so I'm kind of lost a little bit. Now, I don't know about you guys, but I have a bit of a soft spot for Lang anyway, because I really like their music anyway, but I kind of think that this is a bit of a dark horse. I think this could like sneak up on everyone and maybe not win, but I think this could get into the final two.
But well, I have that feeling as well, sadly. Lang is really, had a hit last year, and it was on top of the charts for so many weeks. It was, I'm always feeling tired in the morning, in German.
I know the name of it as well.
Ich bin morgens immer müde.
Yes, morgens immer müde.
And that was a big hit. And I think many people will recognize them because their voices are really special. They're not like somebody mainstream. They have their own style in the voice. I'm not a fan of this genre, actually. I'm more like it appeals to me really much. I think they are really a dark horse. They will definitely be in the top four. I'm not sure about the top two. And in Eurovision, I don't know. Maybe because it's crazy, it could work. I'm not sure.
I don't like his song. It's just nothing. I feel like they used as an inspiration a tune from Super Mario Brothers back to the 20th century, and in no way it's good. It just cuts through my ears. It sounds horrible. I don't like it.
Okay, so that's apparently split us quite a bit then. I think it will depend on sort of whether Germany. It might also be whether they want to send another girl group, because traditionally, when Germany have sent girl groups as well, they've never really done that well. I mean, Eliza did all right, but maybe not as much as people would have hoped. You had No Angels back in 2008.
Yeah, placing last.
Yeah, they were bad. I know some people like that song, but I am not one of them. So will another girl group be a bit too much of an overload? Possibly.
Possibly.
And in a year where you've already kind of got quite a lot of female acts as well, it might be that Germany needs the final person in this running order, which is Andreas Kummer, who won The Voice of Germany, I believe, or was it X Factor Germany?
Yes, no, it was The Voice.
He was the first Voice of Germany, wasn't he? Or he was the most recent one, something like that?
I thought the last year.
He won The Voice of Germany, that's the interesting thing here. So he is the final act in the running order. Does that make him the favourite to win the entire thing?
No. I think he has a good voice, he's strong, but the song is, he picked the wrong song. Like, the second song is better, it's not amazing, it's not, oh my god, it's a good song, but he picked the first one, which is really bad. It's just like a normal song, not even good for your radio, in my opinion. It's just there, and it's... I can't describe it. It's nothing, in my opinion. It's nothing.
Yeah, the song itself is really boring, and I personally don't like the songs where you have just one guitar playing one tune all over the song. It just gets boring, and I don't even want to listen to this guitar, because it has no climax at all. It has no energy. I don't like it.
Yeah, I mean, I think he's very much kind of like a one-trick pony, I think. He hasn't really got that much going for him other than his really good voice, and he's sort of very... You can see what kind of audience he appeals to, and that's probably why he won The Voice of Germany. But after that, there's not really that much there. And at Eurovision, it's just not going to work well for him, I don't think. Maybe the fact that he is a male artist and what is becoming an increasingly female-dominated year, but you've got better songs that use the guitar, and Stig Raster will just wipe the floor with him if he goes there, so...
Yeah, true. No, I don't think that he will going to win. Never. Never, ever.
Well, fingers crossed by the sounds of it. Top four, who do we think that it will be? Who is our picks for the top four?
For me, Anne-Sophie, Fahrenheit, Line, and Noise Generation.
Okay. Misha?
For me, Fahrenheit and Anne-Sophie as well. But I would go for Faun and maybe Alexa or Noise Generation, I'm not sure.
Okay. Well, I am going to stick by my guns because I do love Mrs. Greenbird, and even if she doesn't have a voice, like, the songbirds are going to come down and sing for her instead. So I'm definitely putting those in my top four. Definitely Lang, Fahrenheit, and then I'm kind of up in the air. I think that it will probably be Andreas, even though I'm not a big fan. I kind of hope that it might be Anne-Sophie. I'm not really that sure on the fourth act, but fingers crossed that Mrs. Greenbird can actually perform, because I really want them to do well, at least. And then finally, who do we think will win the entire thing, and who do we want to win the entire thing?
I think it's between Anne-Sophie and Fahrenheit. Personally, I think that Anne-Sophie will win. I have that feeling. But I want Fahrenheit. I really, really want Fahrenheit, because it's something new, something special. They should win.
Yeah, it's the same as me. Like, I really think, want Fahrenheit to win. Well, I think that Fahrenheit has more chances to win than Anne-Sophie or any other act.
Okay, well, I'm going to say that I think Fahrenheit will win, because I do think that they will win. But I am going to kind of stick to my guns and say that I want Lang to win out of the four acts that I've said, because I don't think Mrs. Greenbird will do well. I think Lang might be just a little bit of something different that we might want at Eurovision, and they can finally break the German girl band run of form.
Who knows?
Well, we will find out at Unsersong für Österreich, which is live tomorrow night, and we will let you know what happens. Keep watching and reading on WeWe blogs or on WeWe TV. I am Chris. I have been joined by Patrick and Misha. Thank you very much for watching. Bye.
Bye.